So what's the story with the Secure Act?
Well, it has tremendous bipartisan support. I don't know if I've seen anything like it in the history of 417-3. But it's not that secure, because as of today, I'll have to date stamp this. Where are we? June 9th? It's June 8th or June 9th?
June 9th.
All right. As of June 9th, we know Congress isn't working on Sunday. So as of today, the Senate hasn't agreed to anything. They were going to pass the Secure Act. But either way, there is bipartisan support to move some things they agree on forward. Number one is eliminating the age, 70 and a half, restriction on contributing to a traditional IRA. Right now, you can't contribute to a traditional IRA after 70 and a half, and they figure, well, if people are working, which is more common now, why can't they contribute? But every change is going to come with complexities for accountants, attorneys, and financial advisors. Why? Now, you're going to have money coming into an IRA at 70 and a half, but also it has to go the other way out. In the middle of all of that, you still have qualified charitable distributions, QCDs, going any which way at the same time period. And now they're thinking of moving back the age, both the House and the Senate, to 72, which is kind of good. I don't think it's enough. I mean, it's not a big move. They act like they made a big deal. The biggest thing they did is getting rid of that half year, which confused seniors for years. Am I 70? Am I 71? When am I 70 and a half? So all of that is gone. But if it's 72, now you're going to have this gap for things that hit at 70 and a half, but don't hit till 72. RMDs won't hit till 72, but you still have QCDs at age 70 and a half, and you still have IRA contributions at 70 and a half. So as usual, the tax law will be very complex, and reporting it will be extremely complex. The accountants will have their hands full. So with every benefit comes some confusion, which is always the way with tax law. The biggest thing probably is the elimination of the stretch IRA. Congress never liked stretch IRAs. Congress always felt retirement accounts are for retirement and not for estate planning. Remember, when they started IRAs, they were worried people didn't have anything. And that was why they started IRAs. People retired, they weren't getting their company pensions. Companies were folding, going bankrupt, not paying the pensions. So they said people should have their own retirement account so they have something. Never in a million years did Congress imagine that not only would people have something, but they would have plenty, and plenty to leave over for another generation. So they want to shut that down. Instead of beneficiaries going out 20, 30, 50, even 80 years, the Secure bill says 10 years, that's it, with certain exceptions for spouses, children, disabled beneficiaries. So that's going to change everything. It's going to change how people do estate planning for the largest IRAs, the ones where people did want to have a chunk left for the next generation or even grandchildren. These people tend to name trusts as their IRA beneficiaries. All of that is going to change. So they call this the Secure Act. I think this will be very secure for attorneys, estate planning attorneys, and especially accountants and financial advisors who will have to revisit estate planning for every IRA owner, especially the large ones that have named a trust. The current trusts won't work. And at the same time, the old ones will be grandfathered. So you'll have some people on the old rules, some people on the new rules, but all the planning has to change. It's a Secure Act for financial advisors.